and welcome back in our biology session. So we are discussing our lesson, that is what cell. So in this lesson, or today I will bring you few points from the same lesson, that is what parts of the cell. Okay, so as we know, in our previous video we have discussed about the cell is having a different shape and the size. Okay, so since there is a variation in the shape and the size, but in the cell there are the certain parts are there which are quite similar. Okay, or in the most of the cell there are the some parts which are similar, or we can say there are the some basic parts of the cells are there. Okay, and which are the basic parts of the cell? That are cell membrane, cytoplasm and nucleus. Okay, so these are the basic parts that we can see in each and every cell. Okay, so let's discuss these three parts one by one. First we will go through the cell membrane. What is mean by cell membrane? Okay, so this cell membrane is what? The cell is having the outermost boundary. Suppose this is the cell, then this cell is having this boundary. Okay, and this boundary is called as what? Cell membrane. It is called as what? Cell membrane. Okay, and very important thing is that this cell membrane is also called as plasma membrane or selectively permeable membrane. Now why is it like that? Because this cell membrane is having some pores, or small pores are present on it, which allows the entry for only selected substance. Okay, which gives the entry only for the selected substances to come inside and to go out like that. Okay, which gives the entry only for the selected substance. And that is the reason this cell membrane is also called as what? Selectively permeable membrane, or also it is called as what? Plasma membrane. Okay, or also it is called as what? Plasma membrane. Next one is that with the help of this cell membrane, it provides an outer boundary to the cell. Okay, so this cell membrane provides the outer boundary to the cell. And also very important, with the help of this cell membrane, each and every cell is getting separated from each other. We can distinguish that different cells are there, like this. So all these cells are getting separated from each other with the help of this cell membrane. Okay, so this cell membrane helps to separate out the cells from each other and to find out the, or with the help of that we can come to know the single cell. And also it is the boundary of the cell. Okay, provides a boundary to the cell. Next one is that, but in the one situation or in one case, there is one exception, that is what? In the plant cell and in the bacterial cell. Okay, in the plant cell and in the bacterial cell, there is a one more layer is there. Okay, there is a one more layer is there, and that layer is called as what? Cell wall. Okay, it is called as what? Cell wall. Okay, that layer is called as cell wall. And in which cells it is present? It is only present in the plant cell and an animal cell. Okay, so like the cell membrane is a thin membrane present on the cell, like that there is one more membrane present after the cell membrane in plant cell and in the bacterial cell, and that thin membrane is called as what? Cell wall. So this is about what? Cell wall. Okay, but the question is that why it is only present in the plant cell? Okay, because as we know, the human beings can protect themselves from the different weather conditions. Okay, but if we are telling that the plants is a living thing, but the plants cannot do the locomotion like the other living things are doing. Okay, they have to stand on the one place and they have to suffer from the different climatic conditions. Okay, so to protect the cells or to protect the plants from the different variations in the temperature, moisture and the different natural calamities, this cell wall helps the plants to survive in the different conditions. Okay, so in this way we can say that the cell walls provide the protection from the variation in the temperatures, high speed wind, and also from the different natural things. Okay, or different natural changes. So in this way, this there is the reason this cell wall is present in the plant cell. So up till now we have discussed about what? Cell membrane. In the additional part we have seen in the cell membrane, that is what? Cell wall, which is present only in the plant cell. Okay, now we will move for the next part of the plant, part of the cell, that is nothing but what? Cytoplasm. Okay, So what is meant by cytoplasm? Cytoplasm is a thick jelly-like fluid inside the cell bound by a cell membrane. Okay, so inside this cell membrane there are the thick fluid substance. There is a thick fluid substance, and that fluid substance is called as what? Cytoplasm. It is the jelly-like substance present in the cell. Okay, jelly-like. It is thick jelly-like fluid. As you know, the jelly might be are eating also sometimes. So in this manner, it is a thick and the jelly-like fluid is there, which is present inside the cell membrane, or it get bound by the cell membrane. Bound means what? It get close with the help of the cell membrane, and this jelly-like substance, it is called as what? Cytoplasm. It is called as what? Cytoplasm. Okay. So this jelly-like substance is called as what? Cytoplasm. Okay. So in this cytoplasm, there are so many different chemical activities or the different chemical processes are going on inside the cytoplasm. And also this cytoplasm occupies the space between the cell membrane and the nucleus. Okay. So in this cytoplasm, there is one more organ is present, that is one nucleus, that we are going to see in the next point. So this cytoplasm occupies the space between cell membrane and nucleus. Okay, if we say this is the nucleus, then the cytoplasm occupies the space between the cell membrane and the nucleus. Okay, and whatever the chemical processes are going on in the cell, that all that takes place into this cytoplasm. It also in this cytoplasm there are the different cell organelles are present. For example, we can say that what? Mitochondria, Golgi bodies, ribosomes, lysosomes, vacuoles are there, centrioles are there. All these are the different cell organelles are present in these cytoplasms. Okay, so all these cytoplasmic bodies suspended into this cytoplasm, and then all the cytoplasmic bodies are called as what? Cell organelles. Okay, or in simple word we can say that, but these are the different cell organs which are present in the cytoplasms, and they are only called as what? Cell organelles. Okay. So these are the two main parts of the, now we have discussed, that is what? Cell membrane and cytoplasm. Now we move for the next part of the cell, that is nothing but what? Nucleus. Okay, that is nothing but nucleus. Now we will discuss. So see here, I have drawn one spherical shape part, and that spherical shape part, it is only called as what? Nucleus. It is called as nucleus. So this nucleus is the most important component of the living cell. Very important word, that is what? Living cell. So this nucleus is the most important component of the living cell. What is the shape? It is a large and spherical in structure. Okay, it is a large and spherical in structure. If we do the staining process that we have seen in our previous video, if we do that staining, then with the help of that staining, if we observe that cell in the under the microscope, then we can easily observe this nucleus from the cell. Okay, so this nucleus generally present at the center of the cell in animal cell. Okay, so this nucleus is present at the center in animal cell, and it present at the periphery. Periphery means what? On the border we can say that. Okay, on the border it is present in the plant cell. Okay, so again I will repeat. In the animal cell, nucleus is present at the center, while in the plant cell the nucleus is present at the periphery. Now why is it present at the periphery? Because in the plant cell there are the, due to the presence of the large vacuoles are present in the center of the plant cell, which push the nucleus towards the periphery. What is meant by the vacuoles, that we are going to see in our next point. Okay, so now you keep in the mind that what is in the plant cell, the nucleus is at the periphery due to the presence of the large vacuoles. The large vacuoles are present in the center in the plant cell, which push the nucleus to the periphery. Okay, so this is all about the basic components of the cell, that are cell membrane, cytoplasm and nucleus. So here I have drawn the basic structure of the cell.
said. Okay, basic structure of a cell. Okay, so basically all the cells containing all these three parts. But if it is a plant cell, then the one more part it will contain, that is what? Cell wall. Okay, so this is all about today. Today we have discussed about the parts of the cell. Here we will stop. We'll meet in the next video with the next point. And for today, thank you.